Hey guys, so in this video, I'm going to show you how to set up and optimize your Dash Trader Pro platform. When you first start up your Dash Trader, it's going to look something like this. And by the end of this video, your Dash Trader platform will look something like this. Let's get started. Alright, so the first thing that I like to do is close out all the windows and start from scratch. After all the windows are closed, I like to minimize this menu bar. And that's because we're going to be putting the windows outside of this area. This way, you can have more space using your screen. Alright, so the first thing that I like to do is switch this to dark mode. So that way, it's less harsh on the eyes. To do that, click on the setup tab and click other configuration. On the left side where you see theme, click on the drop down menu. And here you will have three different color layouts. The default, which is mostly white. And then you have the dark mode and the blue mode. I'm going to choose the dark mode. You can pick any that you like. All right, once you're done with that, click OK. All right, so the first window that we're going to add is the order window. This will allow you to see all the orders that you submit. To add this, click on the trade tab and click orders. Once it's out, you'll notice that when you try to move it, it only stays within this space. Right click on the title bar and click pop out. Now you can drag it anywhere you want. I'm going to put it on the top left corner. All right, so once your order gets filled, it will be added onto the positions window. And that's what we're going to be adding on next. Click on the trade tab and click positions. Pop it out again and put it under the orders window. Now all your active positions will show up on this window. The next thing that we're going to add is a watch list. Click on the quotes tab and hover over the market viewer. Here you can create multiple watch lists. For example, you can create a separate watch list for potential short plays, for potential option plays, etc. For this example, I'm just going to click on market view and you can rename this window to whatever you want. Alright, so the next one that we're going to add is the option chain. This is where you'll be able to buy and sell contracts for the option plays. Click on the quotes tab and click option chain. You can drag this anywhere you want on the screen. Now, if you want to change the option chain colors, all you have to do is right click on the option chain and click config. I changed my stripe colors to black and blue and in the money color to green and out the money to red. I also changed the font colors to white. All right, so you can change this to whatever color you want. To change the columns, right click on the chain and click config. Now, I only want to see the last price, the bid, ask, volume, open interest, and change in price. Once you're done with that, click OK. The next one that we're going to add is the Montage Level 2. Click on the Trade tab and click Montage Level 2. This is where you'll be able to see the bid and ask offers. This is also where you'll be able to submit your market orders, limit orders, and stop orders. The next one that we're going to add is a Time and Sales window. This will allow you to see which orders are getting filled. Click on the Quotes tab and click Time and Sales. I like to put it beside the Level 2 window. Now you see this anchor on the Level 2? Drag that anchor to the Time and Sales window. This will connect the time and sales and the level 2. The green color that you see on the time and sales window are orders getting filled on the asking price. The red colors that you see are orders getting filled on the bid price. And the white colors are orders getting filled in between the bid and the asking price. The next window that we're going to add is the chart. Click on the quotes tab and click chart. Now I'm going to add another chart. That way I could look at two different time frames. And that's going to fill up the remaining space. Now drag that anchor from the level 2 to your chart so that the chart automatically changes to whatever ticker symbol you want to look at. I also like to connect the level 2 with the option chain. For example, let's say we want to look at Apple. You can see here that my option chain, charts, and time and sales window all change to Apple. Alright, now I'm going to show you how you can optimize your charts. Right click on your chart and click configure. If you want to see where the pre-market and post-market hours are, then make sure you check this box. And you can change the background color to any color that you want. I chose the gray color because my background color is black. For show title, this is if you want to see the ticker symbol on your charts. I like to see the ticker symbol, that way I can easily identify what I'm looking at. You can also change the size and the position. The next one is the font size and the colors for the labels on the chart. All you have to do is click on this, and here you can change the font, the color, and the size. Now the size that you use will vary depending on your computer screen size and the resolution of your screen. I also like to place my decimals to a maximum of 2. You can see here on the chart, the price of Apple is currently at $175.38, which is 2 decimal points. This is just a personal preference, you can choose whatever you want. Now for the chart background, I chose black, and for the axis color, I chose green. You can also add a footer, and this will show you details of the candle that you hover over. For example, if I hover over this candle, you can see the date, the time, the high and the low, the volume, etc. But I like to leave mine off. But if you want to see this information, then make sure you check this box. For the mouse wheel settings, I put my zoom speed to maximum. This setting is for how fast you want to zoom in and out using the scroll on your mouse. Now for the price axis and space, this is if you want to put a space before the next candle shows up. You can see on my chart, there's a little gap in between the price label and the candle. I have my y-axis margin set to 25. For the top bottom margin, I put 10%. And for the price spacing, I put 3. That way the price labels aren't so close or too far from each other. For the crosshair settings, this is optional, but I like to see the crosshair when I'm hovering over the charts. For save trend line, I like to have this checked. Let's say I have multiple charts open for Apple. If I draw a trend line on one chart, then it will automatically be added onto the other chart. This way, I don't have to individually add the trend line to each one. For example, let's say I want to add a horizontal line on the hourly time frame. You can see that it was also added onto the 5-minute time frame. Now, if you want to add an indicator, right-click on the chart and click Study Config. Here, you can select the indicator that you're looking at. For example, let's say we want to add a VWAP. Click on the VWAP and click Select and click Commit. You can now see a yellow line on my chart, which represents the VWAP. If you want to change the indicator color, right-click on the chart and click Study Config. Click on the VWAP and click Config. Here, you can change the color, the width, and the standard deviation. Let's say we want to change the color to purple and the width to 5. Once you're done, click Commit. You can also change the colors of the candles in this configuration area. Once you're done, click Commit. Here you can see the VWAP is now purple and the width is much larger than before. Now, once you have your chart set up the way you want it to, right-click on it and click Save Settings. That way, when you open up another chart window, you can just load your chart settings onto that. You can also set up hotkeys, and I created a video on how to do this using DazTrader. I'll post the link to the video in the description. To do this, click on the setup and click hotkeys and watch the video that I created. The next thing that I like to set up is the alerts and triggers. Click on the Tools tab and click Alert and Trigger. This is very useful because you can set up price alerts, so when a stock hits a specific price that you're watching, you will be notified with a siren sound or a voice that lets you know that one of your alerts were hit. This also means that you don't have to keep looking at the charts. For example, let's set up a price alert for Apple. Let's say if the price drops below $150 or lower, then you might be interested in buying a long position. To do this, click Add Alert. Create a name for this alert. I'll just put Apple Long. And for the security symbol, put the stock that you're looking at. And in this example, it's AAPL. And here you can set up how the alert will get triggered. For the item, I chose to base this off the asking price. And for the operation, I chose less than or equal to. And for the value, I put 150. This means an alarm will go off when Apple's asking price is less than or equal to $150. You can also customize the sound action. For example, if you want a voice to speak or an alarm to sound. You can also remove the title bars from each window, and this will give you a little bit more space. Now, once you're finished setting up your layout, make sure to save it as a default so that next time you open up your DazTrader platform, it will be ready to go. To do this, click on File and click Save Desktop. Alright, that's pretty much it. You can do a lot of customizations with this trading platform, so make sure to play around and set it up the way you want to. If you have any questions or requests, just let me know in the comments down below. And if you like this video, make sure to subscribe. Thank you for watching.